All right, let's cut to the chase. We're way better. No, seriously. Okay, this is going to be a video talking about the differences between PDF.ai and Adobe Acrobat AI. And every professional works with PDF documents in one way or another, we know. If you don't want to waste your valuable time figuring out which is better, that's what this tutorial is for, and we're going to be as unbiased as possible, even though PDF.ai, obviously our product, trying to do our best here. What can you do? Except tell the truth. So one feature that is getting a lot of attention because it increases productivity in this PDF editor space is the ability to chat with PDFs. And you know about us, but what about the competitors? I'm gonna talk about and explain the features, prices, advantages, and disadvantages, and make a final analysis of all that. So after you're done with watching this video, you can decide which tool is best for you. So PDF.ai is a powerful tool that allows you to chat with any PDF document. From legal agreements to financial reports, PDF.ai brings your documents to life. You can ask questions, get summaries, search for information, and more. More than 1 million users endorse it as a powerful and reliable chat PDF tool. And some of the great main functions of PDF.ai are that you can chat with all of your PDF documents. Inside of something like this, you'll see that I can go through a huge PDF document. I mean, this is not a small document. I mean, this is ginormous. And I have the ability to ask any question under the sun. It integrates with ChatGPT and also has a 4.0 model, which is available for unlimited and above plans. You can save prompts to ask questions very quickly, like generate a quiz from this PDF. And there are so many great integrations with it. You can integrate with Google Drive. Any link that's on the internet that is a PDF can quickly be added to your suite of PDFs that are in your account. It's pretty awesome stuff. Comparing us to Adobe Acrobat AI, from the pricing perspective, PDF.ai is great because you can purchase it for $20 per user per month for this awesome ultimate plan. However, there is a hobby plan, which is $0 per month, free forever, and you are limited to 500 questions per month, which is still pretty great. The pro plan is $10 per user per month as well. Whereas with Adobe, you have a few different pricing plans here. There's the free option, the standard option, and the pro option. And in all instances, the AI add-on is $4.99 per month. Right? So you do have to pay for an AI capability no matter what, which I'm not the biggest fan of. Whereas with our product, at least you could use the free option. Some other great features that we have in PDF.ai is I actually can ask questions in different ways. First of all, there is a feature where I can ask an image from within the document to be kind of translated. So I asked what this image was showing. It was pretty simple. All I had to do is anytime I find an image within here, I can click on this and drag and drop. And then ask a question about it as I did, and it will give a great explanation. But say I speak a different language than this article. I could say, translate a quick summary of this article into Spanish. And it would give you a summary in your language that you would prefer. And not only that, if you have consistent questions that you want to ask, you can go to our little prompt library. You can figure out like what are the key impactful takeaways from the document. And if you're doing the same type of research around these different PDF documents, you can get all the answers you're looking for in a few clicks. That prompt library can be custom made, edited, remove some of them, add them again, whatever you need to do to customize this is totally up to your discretion. And I really enjoy it. And if it gets so big that you need to, you can actually search for it like generate, there we go. It only shows the one that says generate a quiz from this PDF. We have OCR support, which is another big one. Obviously with that image showcase there, I think you can see we have some pretty great image recognizing in our product. Some of the disadvantages are that is if you're an Adobe Acrobat user, PDF.ai won't directly integrate with your product and you can't redeem your ChatGPT subscription to use PDF.ai at a higher level for free, unfortunately. It only supports a PDF file format right now, no Word docs or anything like that. So you know the pricing of the Acrobat Assistant, not gonna lie, it's pretty good for things like meeting transcripts, so you can get more out of your meetings. The free Acrobat Reader itself is a pretty solid product, where you can use it on desktop or mobile, whereas PDF.ai is definitely like a web-based product. But some of the disadvantages of it, I mean, we know it's like a chat interaction with AI sort of thing, but it's only available to English users, whereas we talked about how you can interact with multiple different languages. It's a feature of Acrobat and not exactly a tool itself, so we focus on the AI connected with the PDF, whereas this is just an extension on top of Acrobat, which means that it's charged as a complementary product, and it does lack some important features. We have a Chrome extension. Adobe does not. You can't white label PDF embedding in Adobe. You don't have API access with Adobe. There's a lot of other like very specific features that we're adding to the product. So you can see that's more of an add-on. It's something that does allow you to interact with different documents with AI, but we have those next levels of additions to the product that I think you'll really appreciate. So with that being said, I hope you know that there are some differences between the two products. If you're looking for something that's specifically tailored towards AI and PDFs, check it out. Acrobat AI Assistant is just a step above what their normal product is like. And that $5.99 per month for something that's just like chatting with the text, just a little bit different. With that being said, I hope you like this video and we'll see you in the next one.